So one of the cool applications of point-of-care ultrasound is to use hip ultrasound to diagnose hip effusion. Every pediatric care provider knows that it's really hard to diagnose children to present to the emergency department with a limp and fever. Hip ultrasound can actually be helpful to identify the presence of a hip effusion for those patients. In conjunction with the rest of the physical exam findings, lab investigations, I believe hip ultrasound can be one of the useful tools to guide management of these patients. So in order to achieve proper imaging of the hip, the patient needs to be lying supine with the leg in slight flexion and abduction as much as is tolerated by the patients who are often having some hip pain. So proper pain medication should also be offered to the patient. The probe that should be selected to do hip ultrasound is the linear probe for a younger and smaller patient. And a curvy linear probe can actually be used for adolescent or heavier patients who need a depth of more than 4 to 5 centimeters. When the patient is positioned supine with the hip in abduction, you look at the inguinal crease, and the ultrasound probe actually has to be perpendicular to that hip crease. This actually follows the femoral neck of the patient. When the ultrasound beam is perpendicular to the inguinal crease and parallel to the femoral neck, you can actually visualize the femoral neck, the femoral head, and the acetabulum in the long axis. In order to see whether the patient has a hip effusion or not, what you need to look at is to look at the femoral neck and the iliopsoas muscle next to it. And what you're looking for is you're looking for a hypoechoic kind of fluid collection in this area. The measurement needs to be done at the level of the femoral neck. And if the fluid collection is more than 5 millimeters on the affected side, or if there's a 2 millimeter difference when you compare to the unaffected side, then it's considered a pathologic hip effusion. The trick is to always compare to the other side in order to see if there's a difference. The hypoechogenicity of this hip can actually be tricky because in cases where there's a purulent hip effusion, the area and the fluid collection can be not 100% black, so you should still take it into consideration. Identifying a hip effusion can be quite helpful for a primary care provider, or also seeing that there's no hip effusion can be reassuring. But unfortunately, it doesn't help us differentiate between two different diagnoses, septic arthritis and transient synovitis, which have very different prognosis for the patient. So I think the use of hip ultrasound to diagnose hip effusion is a useful tool when it's used in addition to other clinical factors and lab investigations. So if you like what you saw today, please like us on the channel and we'll have more videos coming.
Glowing big appendicitis on ultrasound, and it has a patient comes in and has a little bit of a proptotic eye.